With spring coming up, a lot of you may be looking to go RVing. And in order to bring, let's say, like your 50-amp RV, you have to power different appliances inside. A lot of campgrounds will have power pedestals available, but let's say those are broken, or you go to a campground without those available. You need a generator to get the power to those appliances. So, what kind of generator should you look for a 50-amp RV? What wattage should you look for? And what kind of different appliances would you be able to power with said generator at a different wattage? To find out those answers, stick around and watch this video. Hi, I'm Chris with AC Connectors, and today we're going to talk about what generator wattage you should look for a 50-amp RV. And for that, we're just going to use the generator that we have on hand here at our facility. So a 50-amp RV will be able to run at up to 12,500 watts for the appliances inside. So that's 50 amps times the 250 volts. And that's how you get the 12,500 watts. So you need a pretty big generator in order to power everything on board there. So this one probably wouldn't be the best idea. So because the consistent running power can be up to 3,800 watts, that's pretty typical for like a 30-amp RV. That other number, the 4,750 watts, that's just to get it started, so don't rely on that. If you were stuck with a generator like this for your 50-amp RV, we would recommend to use the L1430 outlet because that one has two hot wires, so it'll be able to power appliances across your whole RV, whether that be like a 250 volt appliance that you may have to operate on its own for the time being, or if you have like smaller 125 volt appliances like on one end and then some on the other end, having the two hots there will be able to power some on both ends. So if you have a 50 amp RV and you do decide to use the L1430, we have an adapter for you to use. It's RVL 1430, 1450. And it will just go into that outlet there, and you'll be able to connect your 1450 50 amp RV plug with it. But again, there's a big difference between the 3,800 watts and the 12,500 watts. So you kind of have to do some math and figure out which appliances you can run when and kind of time out, depending on what you're doing, which appliances to run. So if you have any questions on this topic or something similar, please leave us a comment down below. Otherwise, be sure to give us a like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.